Hi everyone, here is some information on what items come in your FlightFeeder Orange Kit. I'll be telling you about what some of the pieces do and how to connect it together. Unfortunately, every setup is unique, so we are unable to provide specific instructions on where to place the FlightFeeder or antenna. If you need ideas for mounting or running the cable outside, please see the FlightFeeder Orange instructions on our website or the optional section of the PiAware setup. Let's start with the main part, the FlightFeeder. Inside are several circuit boards that take the signal received by the antenna, translate the signal into a digital stream, and then send the data to FlightAware. There are two main types of messages received by this setup, Mode S and ADS-B signals. ADS-B messages include most of the information needed to track an aircraft, like location, tail number, direction, and speed. Mode S messages, on the other hand, don't include location. So if your station sends a message to FlightAware about a particular aircraft, FlightAware will look for other stations nearby that also sent a message about that aircraft, and if four or more stations send a message to FlightAware, the location of that aircraft can be pinpointed. This is called multilateration, more commonly referred to as MLAT. If FlightAware is able to determine the aircraft's location using MLAT, a message will be sent back to the FlightFeeder and you will be able to view the aircraft on Skyview, which is a web portal to view a map showing the current aircraft the FlightFeeder is receiving messages from. To view Skyview, navigate to the FlightFeeder's IP address in a browser, or a link can be found on the stats page. Communication happens fast, but if an aircraft is being tracked via MLAT, it may take up to a few minutes to display it on Skyview. When setting up the FlightFeeder, you will need to locate an area near power and a network port. Lastly, plan for your setup to be near where the antenna cable will run outside when the antenna is mounted outdoors. Before you do any serious mounting of the antenna, you will want to be sure the equipment functions. To do this, start by connecting the antenna to the cable's N-type connector. The larger connector on the cable is called an N-type connector, and this is what you will screw into the antenna like so. Next up, connect the other end, called an SMA connector, into the FlightFeeder. At this point, you will need to make a decision on whether or not to use the filter. The filter removes unwanted signals and only lets through the 1090 MHz signal the ADS-B receiver is trying to receive from aircraft. Since I'm in the middle of Houston, which is an urban environment, I'll be attaching the filter. If you live in a rural environment, you may choose to leave the filter off. If you aren't sure, try connecting the filter for a few days, then remove it from your setup. If after removing the filter, the number of flights and messages received increases dramatically, then you do not need to reconnect the filter. The number of messages and aircraft your FlightFeeder received can be viewed on the stats page, and a link can be found in the FlightFeeder setup instructions. Or after your setup has sent a message to FlightAware, a link at the top of the page will display called My ADS-B. Click on it to view your stats page and know how your site is performing. The number of messages your FlightFeeder received will be affected by weather and air traffic, so if you are testing the filter, be sure to take that into consideration. If you are choosing to not connect the filter, connect the antenna cable directly to the FlightFeeder. Once the filter or cable is attached to the FlightFeeder and you are planning to use a network cable, please connect the network cable. I'll be connecting via Wi-Fi, and that will be set up after powering it on. Lastly, connect the FlightFeeder to power. If the power adapter comes with the incorrect connector, swap it out by pressing the button in the middle and removing it. Then slide the correct connector on until you hear a click. Once everything is connected, set the antenna upright in a window so it has a clear view of the sky to receive some ADS-B messages. After it is powered up, open the device status. Radio will turn green when a signal is received from an aircraft. MLAT will turn yellow once you've set your location on the stats page, and green when there is synchronization with nearby feeder sites. Network will turn green when the FlightFeeder is connected to the internet. FlightAware will turn green when the FlightFeeder has sent a message to FlightAware and received one back. Wait approximately 5 minutes and check your ADS-B stats page, which will be the link at the top of the FlightAware webpage when you log in called My ADS-B. The The stats page won't be available until your site has received a signal and sent the data to FlightAware, which could take a few minutes or longer depending on your location. To check sooner, look up the IP address in your router's admin page and type that into a browser to see status information. Good luck on your setup, and feel free to email any questions to adsbsupport@flightaware.com. Optionally, if you plan to use Wi-Fi, navigate to the Network, click on Built-in Wireless Connection, select Scan for Wireless Network, choose Your Network, confirm, enter your wireless password, and then hit Save. It may take a while to start from this point. Please give it 5 minutes. If it doesn't function, please contact us at adsbsupport@flightaware.com.